the progress toward HIV cure has gained momentum as innovative approaches, like the new EBT101 CRISPR gene therapy, which holds promise in targeting and potentially eradicating the virus from the human body, show promising safety in ongoing trials. Unlike other gene therapies, this innovation does not need a donor. This has brought a renewed hope and possibilities to millions affected by this global health challenge. EBT101 is spearheaded by a company called Excision Biotherapeutics. This innovative therapy holds promise in combating HIV by precisely targeting and modifying the genetic material of the virus within the human body. Developed with the aim of providing a sustainable cure, EBT101 represents a significant leap forward in the quest to effectively eradicate HIV, offering hope for a future where individuals impacted by this disease can experience a life free from its burden. Initiated last year, the first human trial of EBT101 focuses on individuals with a stable, undetectable viral load due to antiretroviral treatment. The encouraging news emerges from the initial participants in this trial, demonstrating that the CRISPR-based gene editing therapy, EBT101, has not exhibited severe adverse effects. Note that we don't intend to advertise any product or company, but to share this important development toward cure for HIV. First, let's give a simple explanation of the problem this product stands to address. One of the reasons why HIV has been very difficult to cure is because HIV has the ability to persist despite antiretroviral therapy, embedding its genetic code into human cell DNA, forming hidden, resilient reservoirs hidden to both immune responses and medications. These proviruses lie dormant during treatment, but revive once the antiretrovirals cease, making a cure challenging. Viral latency, a significant hurdle in HIV cure research, continues to challenge efforts as current antiretroviral therapy fails to eradicate latent HIV. Hence, patients have to continue to use antiretroviral medications, leading to antiretroviral therapy-related side effects and non-AIDS-related health issues in HIV-positive individuals. To understand this better, you can watch our video on why HIV is difficult to cure. We will add a link to it in the description below. EBT101 aims to tackle chronic HIV infection by targeting three specific sites within the HIV genome for excision, meaning to remove part of the HIV gene, potentially reducing the virus ability to escape cure. The initial trial participants in the first dose group experienced safe treatment without serious adverse effects or dose-limiting toxicities. While four mild adverse effects potentially or definitely linked to EBT101 were resolved without intervention, there were also 12 mild adverse effects. Notably, there were no infusion-related reactions, complement-mediated toxicities, or withdrawals during intravenous administration, except for two participants with transient and reversible liver enzyme elevations. These observations provide crucial clinical data supporting the progression of the EBT101 trial to the next phase. Excision Biotherapeutics plans to monitor participants for 48 weeks post-EBT101 administration, assessing sustained viral suppression after stopping antiretrovirals. Please subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell so that you can be notified when we release the update. While the initial outcomes seem promising, labeling it a definitive cure is premature. Notably, the trial's current results lack data on the treatment's efficacy in controlling HIV. The company anticipates presenting additional data in 2024, potentially shedding light on participants discontinuing antiretroviral therapy and EBT101's impact on delaying HIV resurgence or maintaining viral suppression. However, even if EBT101 maintains viral suppression successfully, there are few challenges ahead. The company will have to move on and do a comprehensive trial involving a larger participant pool, evaluate the long-term side effect, get regulatory body approval, and work on commercialization. Furthermore, considering the high cost associated with existing gene therapies for other conditions, the affordability of CRISPR-based therapy for most people living with HIV globally remains uncertain. Kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified anytime we release a new video with life-saving medical information, and don't forget to hit the notification bell. Note that knowledge is advancing by the day, and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.